So Emma Watson is starring in this new movie called The Perks of Being a Wallflower. Everybody here saw it. And I gotta say, I love this movie. I really, really love this movie. I got sent a DVD of this movie because it hadn't come out yet, and so they sent it to me. And I fell in love with this movie within like 5 minutes of watching it. It is so moving and so real, and I think whether you're a young person, because it's about a group of teenagers in high school, or a not so young person like me, it brings you back to those teenage years in a way that's just so, I don't know, I just found it so real. And while I was watching the DVD, it broke halfway through, and I went crazy because I was so wrapped up in this movie. I was like, I cannot believe it's broken, no. And so finally, they sent me another DVD, and I finished watching it yesterday, and I realized today I woke up kind of sad. And I was like, why am I kind of sad? And I realized I'm sad because the movie is over and I no longer have those characters in my life. It's like when you're reading a really good book and you know you don't want it to end because you don't want your relationship with those characters to end. That's the way I felt about this movie. So I'm so thrilled that Emma Watson and the rest of the cast is here. Also the man who wrote the book, who did the screenplay and directed is also here. Take a look at a scene from The Perks of Being a Wallflower.
Had lunch with Craig today.
Yeah?
He said he was sorry and that I was right to break up with him. I'm driving away and just feeling so small. Just asking myself, why do I and everyone I love pick people who treat us like we're nothing?
We accept the love we think we deserve.
Welcome, Emma Watson. So they all saw the movie. They're all in love with the movie.
Wow.
It's so nice that everybody saw the movie and they're so into it.
Thank you so much. Welcome.
I know. And I feel like because the DVD broke, and I've watched this movie now like twice, basically, I feel like I know you and that we're meant to be friends, even though I don't really know you at all. What I found amazing, too, is that, first of all, that scene where he says we accept the love that we think we deserve, that was like one of those, I felt like Oprah, where I was like, aha, you know? It was like one of those aha things.
Well, it's so funny you say that because that was the line for me when I read the script that was such a revelation. And it hit me like a steam train. I was like, oh my God, it doesn't have to be like this big, awful drama. You could just date someone that's like nice and like wants to take care of you and like is sweet.
The other thing I find amazing about this is that you had to like fight to get this movie made.
This is what I couldn't believe. No one wanted to touch it with a, you know, 10-foot barge pole. So I flew out to LA and met with Paramount and Warner Brothers and Summit and Disney and everyone and was just like, please.
That's incredible to me that you really, Stephen, who wrote the book, the screenplay, directed, is also here. Stephen, you've done such an incredible job.
Thank you. Thank you.
What do you want people to take away from it?
I wanted to make a movie that I'd say like a teenage kid would love because it validates and respects what they're going through. At the same time, that could be nostalgic for their parents. If these two groups can know that they love the same thing, I feel that maybe they can talk to each other a little bit more and we can realize that a generation gap is nothing more than just a conversation we haven't had yet.
Yeah, I think, we got a lot of questions on our wall from Twitter and Facebook. There's a question, which was for you the most difficult scene to shoot and more fun? What was the toughest scene? Because there's a lot of very emotional scenes in it.
Well, I mean, I think for me, it was coming from playing Hermione Granger, who's like this seriously buttoned up, like very prim and proper English schoolgirl, to playing Sam, who's like on the other end of the spectrum, who's like running around in fishnet stockings and feather boas and like doing Rocky Horror and...
Do you have fishnets?
I do now.
You own this role, and I think you're so good, and it's so moving. We gotta take a quick break. We'll be right back. We'll meet some of the Emmy's co-stars from The Perks of Being a Wallflower next.
just want to toast our new friend. You see things, and you understand. You're a wallflower. What is it? What's wrong?
I didn't think anyone noticed me.
Well, we didn't think there was anyone cool left to meet. So, come on, everyone, to Charlie.
To Charlie.
We're back with Emma Watson, her co-star from the new film, The Perks of Being a Wallflower, is also here. Please welcome Logan Lerman. Nice to have you here.
Thank you very much. Nice to be here. Thank you.
So, I mean, in the movie, you guys seem like such good friends. Being together in the cast, did that friendship develop?
Yeah.
We really bonded over, like, it was like, hi, I'm Logan, hi, I'm Emma. And we were like, like, isn't this script amazing? We've got to do it. So we really bonded over, like, wanting to get this.
Had you read the book before? Did you know?
I never read it in high school, though. And then I got the script, and I immediately knew the name. I mean, because it was so familiar to me, and I fell in love with it.
When you get the call that you're going to be working with Emma Watson, what's that like?
Oh, it was great. I mean, she's wonderful. She's a great actress, and I was really excited about it. And the reason why we bonded so much, though, I mean, so quickly as well, is because we were so isolated.
Yeah, we were stuck in this Crown Plaza hotel in the middle of, like, this car parking lot in Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
And basically,
I think I've stayed there. There's not a lot to do.
There's not much to do. Yeah, and none of us really had cars, and we were just kind of,
We lived together, really.
Yeah,
we were living together.
And I heard you'd all play music together and stuff.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
There's another scene that's really powerful in a cafeteria where your brother, who is gay in the movie, is being picked on. Mm-hmm. And let's show the scene, and I'll tell you why I think it's a really important scene. Let's take a look.
You can say something?
Why would I?
You know why.
This is pathetic, man. Your fixation on me.
Do you want your friends to know you got those bruises? Really?
I got jumped in a parking lot.
Where? Shenley Park? Do you guys know about Shenley Park? Do your friends know?
I don't know what kind of sick you're trying to pull, but you better walk away right now. Nothing.
What? Say hi to your dad for me.
Whatever.
What did you just call me?
I just called you a friend.
Please welcome Ezra Miller. He's joining us as well. Ezra, good to have you here. So, one of the things I love about that scene is that, I mean, so often in movies, and I think it's a real credit to Steven, the way he did this and wrote it, is that so often in movies, gay characters are angst-ridden and victimized.
Uh-huh.
And this, your character is, the fact that he's gay is one part of his personality, but that's not what defines him. And he also stands up for himself. I mean, he's just a really cool guy that everybody would want to be friends with.
Yeah, and to have a character in literature who stands up for himself and is not defined by his sexuality, is defined by his personality and his love for his friends and things like that. It was refreshing.
Ezra, you seem very uncomfortable on this set. You seem like you haven't made yourself at home at all. I'm concerned.
You know, I'm just surprised that when I heard that you were interviewing us, I thought we were going to be in a conflict zone.
That's right.
It's actually really cushy. I was expecting to be all like...
We'll see how things go. You never know on this set.
That's true.
We got to take another quick break. We're going to be taking questions from our audience and viewers at home when we come back. We'll be right back. Being a wallflower, Emma Watson, Logan Lerman, and Ezra Miller are here. Ezra's actually tasting Nedla's spinach balls, which is a sentence I don't often say. So we got a question on our Twitter wall. This is from Swix Lerman. Logan, what made you love music? Did you always love music? What about music?
Oh, that's a good question. What made me love music? I was a bad kid. I got grounded a lot.
Did you really?
I did.
And why? What were you doing?
I have no idea. I don't remember the specifics, but I spent a lot of time at home and I kind of just bonded with the piano. That is kind of how it started for me.
Cool. We got a question here for
Hi, I have a question for Emma. Your dress is beautiful, by the way.
Oh, hi.
I was wondering if going to Brown helped you draw inspiration for playing an American teenager, or if you drew that inspiration from somewhere else?
It's also because you never really, I mean, you didn't go to, certainly not an American high school, you grew up really on the set of Harry Potter.
Yeah, I was nervous. I knew I didn't really have my own personal experiences to draw on. I think definitely being at Brown helped, but I mean, I was like pedantically researching everything, and Steve would get these crazy emails from me at like 1 a.m. being like, what is the Olive Garden? I do not... What is this place that you keep referring to? So, you know...
By the way, have you gone to Olive Garden? Because they have the best artichoke dip on the planet. If you've ever been to the Olive Garden, they have the best artichoke
dip. Really? I wish you told me that previously, because I went in and I was like, really?
Okay. And the breadsticks.
All right.
Very good.
Free. They keep coming.
They keep coming, right. Yeah.
They never stop.
And they're brushed with, like, olive oil and butter, basically.
But Olive Garden actually ended up being the one word that you couldn't figure out the accent with, right?
I got there in the end, Olive Garden. I got there. But at the time, I was like, I can't really. The other one I really struggled with was vinyl.
We got more questions here. What do you guys want to ask?
My first question is that you played very, like, heavy scenes in the movie.
Mm.
Where did you find the inspiration to, like, get that emotion?
I mean, you don't need to have had the exact experience that someone else has been through to really be able to empathize and be able to relate to it in another way. But I just, I could relate completely in different ways.
You quick follow-up. It's my birthday, and I'm a huge fan. I was wondering if I could get a hug.
Yeah.
Hey!
I don't believe for a second that it's both of your birthdays, by the way.
Okay.
That old trick. Yeah. That's an old Olive Garden trick, by the way. They give you free meal. There was someone else, I think. Yeah.
Well, Emma, I think you're adorable, and I think you'd make a great couple with Prince Harry. I was wondering if you've ever been asked on a date by a royal.
Oh, I mean, I have not. But the Queen is a lovely lady. I've met the Queen, and yeah.
Have you ever been to Vegas? Because I hear Prince Harry likes Vegas.
That would have been the place to go. I wish someone had told me. No, I mean, I think it's a hard deal being a royal, kinda. I think it would be, that would be intense.
The Perks of Being a Wallflower opens up in New York and Los Angeles this Friday in Moore Theater, September 28th. I really recommend you see this movie. I just think it's a really wonderful film. It's a film for young people and also for adults. Thank you all for being with us. I really appreciate it. You guys are amazing. You can go to AndersonCooper.com to see where you can see it, where to go. We'll be right back.